Hi, welcome to Tech Topics. My name is Russ. Today we'll be walking through how easy it is to customize Windows VMs using Sysprep, which is a new feature in Acropolis 4.6. The first thing we'll need is to have a Windows VM set up. Sean Watkins walks through how to do that in our other Tech Topics video, Managing Windows VMs in Nutanix Acropolis. Once we have the Windows VM set up, we'll then need to generalize it using Sysprep, and we'll reference that command in the description of this video. All right, let's go to Prism. So we've logged into Prism. We'll go to the VM page and the table view. And here we have our Windows Server 2012 reference image that we've created. This is just a Windows Server VM that we've set up and then use Sysprep to generalize. From here, we will clone this VM. We'll select the number of clones. In this case, we'll just say 8. And then select the prefix name. You can also change the starting index number. So if you have some previous clones that you've created and you want to continue with that naming scheme, you can just select a different index number here. As far as the VM resources, we'll leave all those set the same. And then we'll check the custom script box. We will select the upload a file option and choose our Sysprep script. Next, we'll click Save, and this will start the cloning tasks. All right, so our clones have been created. We'll go ahead and power one on and launch the console. So at this point, our Sysprep script that we selected earlier will be being applied to the VM. All right, we'll go ahead and sign in to our VM. The Sysprep script that I used was just a very simple one. We can see here, if we go to the local server, it should have changed the machine name, as you can see here, to test Sysprep. That's really all there is to it. Hopefully this helps make the cloning and customization process easier for you. Stay tuned for more Tech Topics, and thanks for watching.